क्लास 10 मैथ एक्सरसाइज 1.3 एनसीईआरटी क्वेश्चन 1 टू प्रूव दैट रूट 2 इज एन इरेशनल नंबर लेट रूट 2 इज ए रेशनल नंबर एंड रूट 2 इज इक्वल टू पी बाई क्यू वेयर पी एंड क्यू आर एलिमेंट ऑफ इंटीजर क्यू इज नॉट इक्वल टू जीरो एंड पी एंड क्यू आर को प्राइम By squaring we get p square is equal to 2q square which implies p is an even number. So let p is equal to 2k therefore 2k whole square is equal to 2q square which implies 4k square is equal to 2q square which implies 2k square is equal to q square which means q is also even but it is contrary to our hypothesis therefore root 2 cannot be a rational number therefore root 2 is an irrational number similarly we can prove for root 3 and root 5 etc prove that 3 plus 2 root 5 is an irrational number Let 3 plus 2 root 5 is rational number and 3 plus 2 root 5 is equal to p by q which implies 2 root 5 is equal to p by q minus 3 or 2 root 5 is equal to p minus 3 q upon q which implies root 5 is equal to p minus 3q upon 2q which is not possible as root 5 is irrational and p minus 3q upon 2q is rational an irrational number can never be equal to a rational number therefore 3 plus 2 root 5 cannot be rational means our hypothesis is wrong and therefore it is an irrational number exercise 1.4 ncert question 1 to find whether 13 upon 3125 will be a terminating or non terminating decimal by making the factors of denominator say 3125 It becomes 13 upon 5 to the power 5 because denominator has factors of 5 only so it will be a terminating decimal similarly part 3 of question 1 is 64 upon 455 which can be represented as 64 upon 5 into 7 into 13 which is a non-terminating decimal as denominator has factors other than 2 and 5 because 7 and 13 are also factors of denominator similarly find factors of denominator of other questions and if they have factors of 2 and 5 they will be terminating decimal otherwise if they will be factors of 2 5 along with 3 7 11 13 etc then it will be a non terminating decimal in question 2 of exercise 1.4 we have to find decimal expression of those numbers which have terminating decimal so first has 13 upon 3125 which can be expressed as 13 upon 5 to the power 5 by multiplying 2 to the power 5 in numerator and denominator it becomes 416 upon 10 to the power 5 therefore its expansion will be 0.00416 similarly in part 2 it has 17 upon 8 which can be written as 17 upon 2 cube बाय मल्टीप्लाइंग 5 क्यूब इन न्यूमरेटर एंड डिनोमिनेटर इट बिकम्स 17 इंटू 125 अपॉन 10 क्यूब विच बिकम्स 2125 अपॉन 1000 एंड बिकम्स 2.125. सिमिलरली इन पार्ट थर्ड इट इज 61 अपॉन 455 विच कैन बी एक्सप्रेस्ड एज 61 अपॉन 5 इंटू 13 इंटू 7 विच इज ए नॉन टर्मिनेटिंग डेसिमल सो नो नीड टू डू इट. इन क्वेश्चन पार्ट 4 15 अपॉन 1600 कैन बी रिटेन एज 3 अपॉन 320 और इट बिकम्स 3 अपॉन 32 इंटू 10 विच कैन बी रिटेन एज 3 अपॉन 2 टू द पावर 5 इंटू 10 by multiplying 5 to the power 5 in numerator and denominator it becomes 9375 upon 10 to the power 6 which can be expressed as 0.009375. similarly in part 6 it has factor of 2 and 5 so expresses as terminating decimal. And in part 9 which has 35 upon 50 it can also be represented. Other decimals are non-terminating so no need to do in this question. Question 3. It requires whether the sums given in question 3 will have factors of 2 or 5 of other than that. 43.123456789 is a terminating decimal. So prime factors of denominator that is q are of nature 2 to the power p into 5 to the power q where p and q will be elements of integer or positive integer. In part 2, the question is 1200, 1200, 1200. Zeros are going on increasing after 12, so it is an irrational number. It cannot be represented in the form of P and P by Q. In part 3, 43.123456789, it has recurring from 1 to 9. So Q has factors other than 2 and 5 as it is a non-terminating decimal. Thus, chapter 1 of